I'm Major Kira Norris, and I'm the first officer of the station. I have a very strong belief system, very spiritually oriented, and very much a nationalist. Very much want to see the Bajorans get themselves together as a people.
I guess it's time to meet Major Kira.
Sir, have you ever served with any Bajoran women?
No, why?
I was just wondering, sir.
When the series started, she was pretty shell-shocked being. She'd come out of an occupation. She'd been a freedom fighter, so she fought. She killed. She'd, you know, slept under rocks and in caves and had as harsh a life as in present day what we observe on TV in the war-torn areas. And she comes into this perfect environment of the Federation and hates them. Hates the whole image, hates the whole concept. It's not, basically she would have loved to have taken someone by the shoulders and said, it's not really like that out there. You know, you can make it all nice and neat, but it is not, it is still not like that.
Yes.
I'm Benjamin Sisko.
I suppose you want the office.
Well, I thought I'd say hello first and then take the office, but we could do it in any order you'd like.
Hello.
Kira came to the station, an angry woman. I think when we were watching the initial dailies of the pilot and we looked at it, we said, this is a very angry woman. Being a child of the Bajoran occupation is not the way to grow up. So she was a very angry, distrustful woman. And I think she has grown and relaxed over 7 years. I think is a wonderful character, and I think the relationship that she's been able to form with Odo is truly a charming and lovely relationship. And she's a very strong woman. The toughest broad in the galaxy, we like to say.
Is something bothering you, Major?
I have been fighting for Bajoran independence since I was old enough to pick up a phaser. We finally drive the Cardassians out, and what do our new leaders do? They call up the Federation and invite them right in.
The Federation is only here to help
us. Yes, I know. The Cardassians said the same thing 60 years ago.
We're highly aggressive females, Bajorans. It's a little bit like the ancient Celts. Celtic women were warriors right along with the men, and just as wild as the men. And that's what Bajoran women are like. So I'm not one to wait around to ask permission. I will act. And if it takes physical strength, that's what I'll use.
Glad to see that living on a space station hasn't slowed you down.
We were a group of actors that were very experienced, mostly theater. And we took it all very seriously. People were used to coming from other sets where everyone fooled around. And towards the end of the 7 years, we did. To a certain degree, but we were pretty serious about our work and scenes and what each character was getting out of them. And I think that that made a difference to the kind of work that we put across.
I know all your secrets now.
Is that so?
You'll pay for that death and all the others you're responsible for.
Well, I don't think I could pay for all of them, Major. There were so many. And you can only execute me once.
It's my only regret.
From the first season, I thought Duet, which was the show with Major Kira, Nana Visitor, and a Cardassian war criminal. It was basically a two-character show. I thought that was gangbusters. It still works today. It's very powerful. That's a wonderful episode.
Look, I regret a lot of what I had to do.
How convenient of you.
We had no choice. We were fighting for survival.
So were we. We had an empire to protect. We needed your resources. Everything I did was for the greater glory of Cardassia. And if you spineless scum had to be ground under, so much the better. All that mattered was Cardassia. I loved my homeland. That's what justified my actions. That's what gave me strength.
Nothing justifies genocide.
What you call genocide, I call a day's work.
It was fun because I got to stretch and go on rides that you don't get to go on if you're not with really good actors.
You know what they say about tennis, if you play with someone better than you, your game goes up. It's the same with acting.
Why are you doing this?
For Cardassia. My trial will force Cardassia to acknowledge its guilt. It will guilty all of us. My death is necessary.
What you're asking for is another murder. Enough good people have already died. I won't help kill another.
After 7 years, you see this woman gaining security, being fed every day, sleeping in a normal bed, and becoming used to having friends and people that she can confide in. She has a very close friend on the station, Odo, and the shapeshifter. And with security, she gets to evolve in different areas, and she does. Still with her mistakes, still with her problems and things to get over, which makes her interesting, always made her interesting to me.
You are me, aren't you?
I'm Kira Nerisse.
That makes two of us.
Well, she's interesting because she's Kira. She's got all, you know, it's all the same. Everything is exactly the same, except in this other world, her ego's twisted one way where Kira's twisted another. So where Kira thinks of others and finds a justification for her life in doing things for other people, the intendant's justification for life is in doing things for herself. She's completely the most self-involved, self-centered person. She's like a child in that sense, which makes her funny. But in her childish way, she cares so little for other people. She thinks nothing of disposing of them, using them. It doesn't matter, which makes her very scary. I walked that line. Sometimes I got it right, sometimes I didn't. Sometimes she just became diva. Sometimes it was very effective, but it was an interesting character to play. And I, you know, when she comes over and meets Kira, she falls in love with Kira. My intention always was that it was pure narcissism. It was simply someone that looked like her. It had nothing to do with it being a woman. But in subsequent episodes, it's just she became, you know, it just didn't matter. I assume, you know, lizards would have been all right with her too.
You don't trust me. I'm a little afraid of you. Then you fear yourself. I don't want your fear. I want your love.
As an actor, it's always interesting to go to the complete opposite of something that you've been playing. It's almost like a good acting exercise, because I'd come back to Kira and realize just where she was, and that I don't have to push her being caring individual. When you go to the exact opposite and be completely uncaring, it balances you nicely. I like that. I remember sitting there terrified, thinking, you know, I'm going to be written off the show. That was like my worst fear. I'm not going to be on the show anymore because I'm pregnant.
What you're telling me is that Major Kira is going to have my baby?
It was maybe the next day the writers came up with this idea that there's a shuttle crash and Keiko is carrying her baby and we have to take the baby from Keiko and I'm the only available womb. And I thought that was damn clever, I really did. I thought that was a great way of handling it without making Kira a mother, per se, and have to deal with that.
You know, what you're doing for me, for us, I don't know how to thank you.
Oh. Keiko, this is your baby.
That's something I wish we'd been able to delve into more. The complications and what that actually feels like. I had just given birth the whole storyline was designed to help me, to allow me to be pregnant while we were shooting and not have to hide behind tables every second. And having just given birth myself, It's got to be very complicated emotionally for women who do this, who give up children, and, but, you know, that's another series. I thought it was a friendship. Kira thinks it's a friendship, solely. Evidently, Odo fell in love with her, but thought it best not to mention it, not to change the relationship. So it went on for a long time that way, where he had feelings for her and she had no idea, which was really difficult for me to play, because I thought, come on, don't you know? I mean, you've got to be able to tell when someone's looking at you moony-eyed. But then I found out that Siddig actually had felt that way about me before I was aware of it, so that made me take it all back.
Are we going to have dinner together or not?
And if we do, then what?
I don't know. Maybe we could go dancing.
And after that, I suppose you'll expect me to kiss you.
Well, it's possible.
But then who needs dinner? Why don't I just get it over with and kiss you right now?
Well, why don't you?
I think Odo and Kira, the evolvement of their relationship from friendship to lovers, is one of the only real mature love relationships I see around. It's very nice and very intimate.
You're right. Who needs dinner?
In this last season, I've become a colonel. We've really gotten heavily into the war with the Dominion. It's interesting, you know, I became a colonel and it was definitely Kira's on the administrative side. And that was a whole arc for my character. She's got to use her mind and not her brawn so much. But the writers in their wisdom found a way to get me back to the beginning by sending me to Cardassia to have to train these Cardassians to be terrorists as I was, or freedom fighters as it were. And that brings up the old fighter in Kira and all the visceral responses and a lot of old memories. So the Kira that you see in this final arc is kind of a revisit in an interesting way. She's older, wiser, all of that, but she's still kind of scrappy, I guess you'd say.
You must be Colonel Kira.
I'm sorry I wasn't at the airlock to greet you when you arrived, but I was...
No need to explain, Colonel. You must be quite busy.
I hope you find your accommodation satisfactory, other than the chairs, of course.
I think, maybe foolishly, but I think we could have gone on. I think there were more stories to tell. But it's a good place to end it. I think it could go on from the way the last episode is. I think you could start again the next year with what's happening now. But it's got to end sometime. Kira comes full circle, but, you know, going full circle, she's explored all the degrees all the way around the circle this time. So she's pretty much in the same place, but not the same person at all. There's a depth, and there's an understanding, and an experience that only, you know, going the whole way around the trip gives you. So that's why the way it ends is very satisfying for me as an actor, as the keeper of Kira. She comes full circle.